also a very nice car, nice and sporty. You know, I enjoy it quite a lot. Vic, if you can just explain the start-stop thing that
you know, what BMW are doing now with the efficient dynamics is they've got this function where the car will, when you come to a stop, if everything is optimal in terms of the battery charge and the temperature in the cabins to what you set, the car will automatically switch itself off. And the minute you take your foot off the brake or turn the steering wheel, it'll automatically start again and you carry on driving to save the emissions and obviously fuel. And a lot of people ask us, you know, what happens if we get to a stop street and, you know, there's a hijack and the car doesn't start, you know, fast enough, but it's almost impossible to catch it out. The minute you take your foot off the brake, the car started before you can touch the accelerator. So it's a pretty novel feature and obviously in line with saving the atmosphere and the planet.
Yeah, I've spoken to him this morning about his little accident he had. And you know, funny enough, the team player that here is, the moment he bumped into the person in front of him, the first thing he thought about was, I need to phone the guys because I'm going to be late for golf. So, you know, that really sums up the type of person here is. You know, he's always thinking about the other people. I found out this morning as well that when he got out of the car, he actually gave the lady in front of him a hug because she was hysterical and she was crying and everything. And you know, he's a better person than I am. I think I'll be a bit pissed off when that happens to me. But you know, I take my hat off to Gio for doing what he did. I think it's a wonderful gesture. Well, we did a lot of fitness, and I think you know the heat was a massive problem. So you know, the funny thing would have been to see me do fitness in that heat. I think they would have loved to see that. It was quite funny. I looked like a 94 year old man, you know, trying to run, but at least you know we worked hard and we got it all done. We had groups. Now before you go and camp, they'll divide us into groups, and then the last day of the camp we had to do an a cappella, and we did Rolling in the Deep by Adele. And you know, we went to a costume higher place, and you know, we hired costumes, and I was Elvis. I went for the Elvis vibe, which I believe I pulled off quite significantly. Had a great time doing it. The other guys did Michael Jackson, and it was really fun, and it was something that you know, you can see the enthusiasm of the guys, the amount of work we all put into it. I mean, I don't think we were that enthusiastic about our rugby training for quite some time. So yeah, we enjoyed it a lot. We had great fun. There were some good singers and there were not so good singers.
Who was the worst?
I reckon the worst was Andries, because he doesn't like singing, so he didn't say a word. Andries was the tallest background singer I've ever seen in my life, and I think he was humming it because he wasn't singing. It was great. We really enjoyed it. It was great fun. I must say that I was told by two of the judges, and there were only three, that if there was an individual performance reward, that I would have won the individual performance.
Perfect. Give us.
That being said, that happened.
Ducking it. Yeah.
After six beers.
Dipping in the
evening. And about two tequilas. So if you don't have six beers and two tequilas in this car, then that won't happen today.
I've got.
Have you got? Okay, then I'm in trouble.